The views and opinions expressed on Detroit Wants to Know with Steve Hood are not those of WADL TV 38 or Adele Broadcasting Corporation.
Detroit Wants to Know is brought to you by Venn Johnson, attorney and counselor, Johnson Law PLC.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38 WADL. In downtown Detroit, there's a new jail being built. It's 715,000 square feet. It's going to house 2,152 prisoners, and it's going to cost over $300 million. And you say, whoopee, is that going to make jobs? Yes, it's going to make about 2,500 jobs over its lifetime span, over the time of construction. Here's the problem with it, ladies and gentlemen. During Turkiya Mullen's outburst and boastfulness about her having to take a decrease in salary to go work for the airport, she admitted that she made $75,000 off a nonprofit. This nonprofit was set up to fund Mr. Fucano, the Wayne County executive's trips to China, his trade missions, which is, on its surface, is a good purpose. You don't want public funds paying for trade junkets. Problem is that the nonprofit was listed at the home address of Turkiya Mullen's sister. Problem is, contractors gave to that fund. She was paid $75,000, and she sat in on the selection process of the person, of the company that was to get the jail contract to build the $300 million jail. Ladies and gentlemen, this stinks to high heaven, and I believe the Wayne County Building Authority, because the Wayne County Commission has passed all oversight to the Wayne County Building Authority, ought to halt construction and review all of those bids. I have with me today Michael Schwartz and Vin Johnson. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Actually, good morning, gentlemen. Michael Schwartz, if this was Kwame Kilpatrick, would he be allowed to get away with it? A contractor giving money to a nonprofit, that nonprofit paying somebody on the board who actually had oversight and involvement in the selection process of a contractor getting a $300 million deal.
You know, he'd probably get indicted for it, unfortunately, and you know, he's a former client of mine. He's already been indicted. A lot of the things that are happening over there need to be looked at real carefully. I'm glad to see that the FBI and the U.S. attorneys are getting into it. It would have been nice if the attorney general also got into it because there are state crimes involved.
He's what state crimes?
Well, you can have anything from extortion to fraud. There are a lot of state crimes. They're not all necessarily federal crimes, because the federal crime, you have to have certain nexus. For example, if you have fraud, plain fraud in and of itself is a state crime. If you have fraud using federal tax dollars, that'll get a federal thing into it. If you're using a telephone, that's called wire fraud. If you're using the U.S. mails, it's called mail fraud. Those are federal crimes. But some of these crimes may be, assuming that there are crimes, state crimes, and you'd like to have state authorities looking into it, because the federal government cannot prosecute state crimes. They can only prosecute crimes that are stated as crimes by the Congress when they enacted the laws. So it'd be nice if Mr. Schuette stepped up to the bar and did his job as well.
Vin Johnson, super criminal attorney. What do you think about all this crap?
It smells, obviously. And what you need to understand is Ms. Mullen is a licensed attorney. So she understands the word fiduciary duty, and fiducia, the Latin term means trust and confidence. And Steve, what we have here
I just learned something. Fiduciary, fiducia, trust and confidence.
That's where it comes
from. Write that one down, citizens.
And, by the way, it's the highest degree of trust. And I should point out, I don't want to interrupt Ven, but not only is she a licensed attorney, so is Bob Fucano.
And continue.
But that's an important point for the public to know, what Michael was talking about, and that, Steve, is that in addition to the fact that she is a public official and you owe the highest duty possible, meaning she has to be above reproach. She has to avoid what's called the appearance of impropriety. Mm-hmm. So if she's cutting a deal, or if anybody, by the way, in government is cutting a deal for self-pay over what's good for the taxpayer, then it is absolutely wrong, and more importantly, it's against the law. So there's no question. And as a lawyer, a practicing lawyer who understands what fiduciary duty, that's the kind of duty that Michael and I would owe to one of our clients. We have to put their interest far above ours. And if there's ever a question, then we have to bring that to the attention of the appropriate individuals. And in this particular case, not only was there this public, if you will, profit, or non-profits, what it's be calling. If it's non-profit, how can it be paying her $75,000? But there's apparently some evidence, Steve, that there was a local non-profit that was paying somebody $75,000. And again, the problem is, as we all know, is it's the same companies that put money into that ultimately got the bid.
And that's what we call conflict of interest. In fact, the whole idea that you're going to have people who are going to pay an official who's going to pass on their proposal, pay them through an indirect means. You cannot do indirectly that which you cannot do directly. You can't go out and pay her the money, because we would call that at the least an unlawful gratuity, and some people might call it a bribe. You can't do that. In fact, there are other things you've got to look at. For example, when she got her money, the $200,000, she couldn't get it the way she got it, even if it was allowed, because that had to go to the county commission, because it was over $99,000. Mm-hmm. It didn't go there. Big question, why not?
Michael Schwartz, one last question. Am I wrong in saying that race is playing a factor here, and that's why they haven't been updated, they haven't been investigated to date?
No, I wouldn't say that necessarily, because I don't know that. And before I would make an accusation, I'd have to have some basis to do it. Mm-hmm. But I know this much. Bob Ficano has a lot of questions to answer. He claims at one point that he had to pay because there was a contract. Then he said, no, there wasn't a contract. Then he said, well, I had this document, this undated document, mm-hmm. which he said he signed. Then he said, well, he didn't really sign it. Mm-hmm. And he's got a lot of other questions. And you've got to take a look at the relationship, not only between her and Turquia Mullen and him, outside of their professional right. relationship. You've got to also take a look to see what, if any, relationship there was between Turquia Mullen and John Rakolta, who
John
happens to
Rakolta.
Be the man
there
who's
goes
building,
the name. I'm glad you mentioned that
building
name.
The jail that you're talking jail. About. You've got to take a look and see, what? Is there any relationship outside of professional mm-hmm. relationship between the two of them?
Well, when we come back, as the world turns, we're going to have Kevin McNamara on here. Michael Schwartz, thank you for taking the time out to join us.
May the Schwartz be with you.
Thank Ben you. Johnson, you stick around with me, all right?
Yes,
ladies
sir.
And gentlemen, we'll be right back. Your tax dollars depend on it.
Hello, I'm Doris Fisco. And like you, I've been wondering what impact health reform will have on my medical coverage. The new health reform law is full of changes. Some are phasing in now, and others are over the next 10 years. Many affect Medicare beneficiaries. HAP's specially trained staff can help you understand the impact of health reform on your Medicare options. During this Medicare annual enrollment period, HAP is conducting Medicare workshops where you can learn about the changes created by health reform and get answers to your questions about how they affect your plan options for 2011. There are also special materials to make your 2011 decision as easy as possible. Or you can speak with skilled staff by phone or in person. HAP has been here for me and my family. You can rest assured they'll be here for you too. If you'd like to learn more, call 800-808-2777. It's time to get informed about reform.
On October 12th and 26th, only AFPD member stores are offering 3-pound bags of Michigan-grown red or golden delicious apples for 99 cents a bag. Call 1-800-666-6233 for the nearest AFPD member store. Sponsored by the AFPD, the voice of the independent retailer.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38. Last week, Wayne County CEO Robert Ficano apologized for a $200,000 payout to an appointee, severance payout to an appointee that went to go work for the airport. Further, he said that things were done wrong, and then he suspended his deputy county CEO, he suspended his corporation counsel, and he fired a contractor. Too little, too late. The only problem is, ladies and gentlemen, the letter that was signed was actually, this giving her the severance was signed the day she started her new job. Bob Ficano said this was to memorialize an agreement that was made when she started. Vin Johnson, this sounds like a dereliction of fiduciary responsibility. It also sounds like converting private funds, I mean public funds, to private use. And it sounds like a violation of the Hobbs Act. Am I off base?
No, I think that there's an argument to be made that all of those could be true, but you know where I come from as a licensed and practicing attorney, you're innocent until proven guilty. Hobbs Act is a federal public corruption crime that's used in very, very small instances, but you know, with the federal government, they can come after you if they think that you're doing something corrupt and wrong. But what to me it's more important about that whole thing that you just said, Steve, is that we have a letter from the chief executive of Wayne County that is undated. Undated. Mm-hmm. When was it done? I don't know. Was it done when the contract first was entered? Is that a contract? But I got one other thing for you. That's not severance pay. Severance pay is not what you get when you voluntarily leave your job. Severance pay is what you get when your employer either terminates you, fires you, or otherwise lays you off, and then they give you some amount of money saying, we know it's going to take you a while to get back on your feet, and that is not $200,000.
Kevin McNamara. In fact, I didn't introduce you to him. This is Kevin McNamara, Wayne County Commissioner.
Hello.
Kevin, have you ever seen the like? You've been around politics for years. Have you ever seen the like?
Severance agreements usually occur when you bring people from private industry from other states in, and you know, they give up their career to take a chance on for a short period of time to fix up a community. It never, ever happens when you quit at will. When you voluntarily say, I quit and take a better job. I've never, ever heard of it.
What's the commission going to do?
We're gonna
are you guys just going to sit there?
No.
Or are you going to get to the bottom of this?
No, we're going to continue investigating. We're moving ahead strong. I mean, obviously, with the FBI involved, they're going to take care of the criminal component of this. They're not a very transparent organization. The commission is the most transparent organization you can possibly think of. Everything is filmed. Every meeting is an open meeting. We're going to move forward with our investigation, and our investigation will be transparent.
If your investigation should lead to real wrongdoing, all right, though Mr. Vicano has fired underlings, suspended underlings, will you take it all the way and replace Bob Vicano? Use the commission's right to appoint another county executive.
You know, if it comes to that far...
I mean, are you guys afraid? Everybody's saying
that Bob Vicano has
given so many donations that people are afraid to challenge him.
No,
are you guys afraid?
You're seeing Bob Vicano's staunchest advisors, staunchest people that back him in the commission are all rising up and saying, you know, this doesn't pass the smell test. We want answers. We want to know what is going on here right now.
It smells worse than me having a hydrocolonic.
Well, yeah, when I hear the FBI wanting the... when I hear the FBI is coming in, the Wayne County Commission is an investigative body. I mean, we do investigate. We have researchers, we have auditors, but we don't do criminal investigation. We've never done that before in our lives. Mm-hmm. The FBI is probably the finest criminal investigative group in the world. If they find that there was criminality involved, they prosecute. That's their job. That's what they do. At that point, yes, the County Commission will do its
necessary
recourse.
So if they find criminal wrongdoing, you all do not have the problem pulling the trigger?
Oh, no. We will have to pull the trigger. We will pull the trigger.
Vin Johnson, any more comments?
Well, again, I commend Kevin and the commission for doing what the right thing is in investigating. It restores public faith in people. And what I think that the county needs to really focus on is look at these severance packages, if you will. It doesn't happen in my profession, I can tell you that. It doesn't happen in most professions I know, but if that's what happens in the public domain, if you will, then it should be, just like Kevin's saying, open. There should be a contract. It should be dated. And there should be a public record made as to who gets it, who doesn't, and under what circumstances. But as Kevin just admitted, it never happens when you voluntarily leave a situation. So this severance deal of $200,000 was not a severance deal.
Okay. Vin Johnson. County Commissioner Kevin McNamara, thank you for joining us. Ladies and gentlemen, the message, if you didn't hear loud and clear, if the FBI finds that Robert Vicano did wrong, the commission will act and he will be out of there. When we come back, we're going to talk about some other type of violence. Your mind depends on it. See you soon.